The world of microbes. In this lesson, we are learning about Louis Pasteur, swan neck experiment, vaccines, the world of microbes, shapes of bacteria, and the types. Okay? Which are the types of microbes? Bacteria, viruses, protozoa, algae, and fungi. And the diseases which are caused by the microbes. Okay? And the antibiotics and the vaccines. We can find so many things around us. We are seeing so many things. Okay? Of these, some are living and others are non-living. Of those living, you can find varieties of plants and animals. And there are so many organisms which cannot be seen through our naked eyes. We can see plants and animals through our naked eyes, alright? But we cannot see microorganisms through naked eyes. Okay, the organisms, what are microorganisms? The organisms which cannot be seen through our naked eyes are called as microorganisms. Okay, here is an activity. You collect a pond water taken in a small clean glass bottle. Place a drop of water on a clean slide. You have to add methyl cellulose. What is the purpose of adding the methyl cellulose? It's nothing but to slow down the movement of protozoa. Place the cover slip over the above suspension. You have to examine under low power and high power objectives. Then we can find tiny organisms moving around. These are nothing but microorganisms. From the above activity, it is clear that microorganisms can be seen through microscopes. Golden age of microbiology. Golden age of microbiology began with the work of Louis Pasteur, okay, and Robert Koch. Louis Pasteur is from France and Robert Koch is from Germany. They discovered many agents of different infectious diseases. And they also discovered how to prevent the spreading of diseases. Louis Pasteur, he lived in between 1822 and 1895. What are the contributions of Louis Pasteur? The contribution of Louis Pasteur, France, in the field of microbiology led to a greater understanding of human elements and animal diseases. Much of Pasteur's work involved in the growth of bacteria and yeast in liquid cultures. Pasteur developed methods of sterilization and pasteurization. He observed different kinds of microbes associated with different kinds of fermentation. For example, yeast cells, spheres of variable size with alcohol fermentation and rod-like lactobacilli with lactic acid fermentation. This finding led Pasteur to state that specific microbes are responsible for the specific diseases in man. His crowning achievements were pasteurization of milk, the development of technique to reduce the virulence of infectious organisms without eliminating their capacity to produce immunity. In this way, he developed vaccines for the control of cholera and rabies in man. Okay, here is the swine neck experiment. The infusion was boiled for a long time to kill all microorganisms present. After several days, no microorganisms appeared in the infusion. The flask was tipped to allow the trapped microorganisms to enter the infusion. Microorganisms quickly multiplied in the infusion. Here is swine neck experiment. Pasteur had to disapprove spontaneous generation to sustain his theory, and he therefore designed a series of swine neck flasks. He took little broth in the flask and boiled the broth, okay? Then he left the flask open to the air. Only the air free from dust particles entered the flask. While dust particles and microbes get trapped in the bent portion, microorganisms are trapped in the bent portion of, here we can see, bent portion of the neck. After few days, he broke the neck, took a sample of broth and examined under microscope. He found no microorganisms. Based on this, Pasteur concluded that living organisms do not arise from non-living matter. Okay, this is the disapproval of the spontaneous generation. That is nothing but living organisms do not arise from non-living matter. This clearly indicates the disapproval of spontaneous generation. Spontaneous generation means living organisms can arise from non-living matter. Okay, here it is disapproved. Thus, Pascal's experiment disapproved the theory of spontaneous generation. He also encouraged the belief that microorganisms are in the air and could cause diseases. Microorganisms are responsible for causing the diseases. Pascal postulated the germ theory of disease, which states that microorganisms are the causes of infectious diseases. Pascal considered as father of microbiology. Robert Koch, 1843 to 1910. Robert Koch, his contemporary to Pascal. He also made his contributions on new procedure for staining, visualizing and growing bacteria. He solidified liquid culture media with agar. He also isolated and characterized the bacilli of anthrax and tuberculosis and also demonstrated their causative role by a series of experiments. After identifying the anthrax bacillus, Koch advocated his postulates that the disease agent can be present in every affected case and absent in healthy individuals. The disease agent can be present in every affected cases and absent in healthy individuals. Okay, the agent can be isolated. The diseased agents, microbes can be isolated and cultured in vitro. In vitro is nothing but that is cultivated in a laboratory environment. Disease can be produced when a pure culture of pathogen is inoculated into susceptible host. Disease can be produced when culture of pathogen is inoculated into susceptible host. The agent must be recoverable from infected host. He was awarded the Robert Koch was also awarded the Nobel Prize in the year 1905 for his work on tuberculosis. Where do microorganisms live? Microorganisms are widely distributed in nature and exist as unicellular, multicellular or cell clusters. Some microorganisms are beneficial and some others are harmful. The major types of microbes are bacteria, fungi, protozoa, algae and viruses. Bacteria. Bacteria are unicellular organisms. The cells are described as prokaryotic because they lack definite nucleus. Bacteria are single-celled organisms and they are also prokaryotic. What is the meaning of prokaryotes? They lack definite nucleus. Here is an activity. Take a small amount of curd and put a drop of curd on a clean microscopic slide. Spread the curd drop evenly and prepare a thin smear. Dry the smear by heat fixation by passing the slides 5 to 6 times over a spirit lamp. Add methylene blue stain on the curd smear and leave it for 1 minute. Remove excess of stain by washing the slide with water. You have to observe the slide under a compound microscope under low power and high power and while immersion objectives. You can see tiny objects we see are the bacteria which convert milk into curd. They are rod-shaped. Rod-shaped bacteria are called bacilli. The bacteria that you have observed in curd sample are lactobacilli. What are lactobacilli? Lactobacilli are nothing but the bacteria that you have observed in the curd are called as lactobacilli. Here we can see lactobacilli. We can find bacteria of different shapes. They exist in different shapes. Rod-shaped bacteria are called as bacillus. Spherical shape are called as coccus and spiral shape are called spirilla. And curved-shaped bacteria are called as vibrio. By observing the figure, we can find know that cocci bacteria may be single in pairs or clusters and in chains. Coma-shaped bacteria are called vibrio. Spiral-coiled bacteria are called spirilli. Here we can see bacteria shapes. And here is a typical structure of bacterium. Here we can see flagellum, cytoplasm, ribosomes, nucleoid or DNA, plasma membrane, cell wall, capsule and plasmid and pili. Viruses. Here we can see some of the examples of viruses. This is nothing but HIV virus, HIV or human immunodeficiency virus, TMU are tobacco mosaic virus and pox virus. Viruses are non-cellular entities that consist of nucleic acid core. The nucleic acid, it may be either DNA or RNA. DNA or RNA is surrounded by a protein coat called capsid. Nucleic acid and capsid together form nucleocapsid. The nucleocapsid may be naked or surrounded by a loose membrane called envelope. Viruses contain only one type of nucleic acid, either DNA or RNA. Viruses are infectious agents. They are much smaller than the bacteria. When compared to the bacteria, viruses are much smaller. Their approximate size ranges from 20 to 300 nanometer. They can be seen only through electron microscope. For examples, HIV, TMU and pox viruses. Viruses are incapable of independent growth in artificial media. They cannot be grown in artificial media. They can grow only in animal cell or plant cell or in microorganisms. Hence, they are referred to as obligate intracellular parasites. What do you mean by obligate intracellular parasites? That is nothing but they cannot complete their life cycle outside the host cell. They can complete their life cycle only inside the organisms or host. Okay, it may be animal cell, plant cell or microorganisms. Because they lack metabolic machinery of their own to generate energy or to synthesize proteins. They depend on the host cell to carry out these vital functions. There is a group of viruses which infect bacteria. These are called as bacteriophages. What are bacteriophages? Viruses which infect bacteria are called as bacteriophages. These viruses infect the bacteria and multiply inside the host cell. Cause lysis of bacteria. Lysis means breakdown. Okay, here we can see DNA viruses and RNA viruses. DNA viruses means which contain DNA as a genetic material, and RNA viruses means which contain RNA as genetic material are called as RNA viruses. DNA viruses, hepatitis B, pox viruses, herpes simplex virus, varicella zoster virus, etc. RNA viruses, HIV, influenza virus, polio virus, mumps virus, etc. Viruses do not respond to antibiotics. Viruses live and replicate inside a host cell. Viruses insert their genetic material into a host cell's DNA in order to reproduce. However, antiviral medicines and vaccines are specific for viruses. Here we see typical structure of a bacteriophage. Here we see head, neck, collar, sheath, tail fiber, base plate and DNA. A bacteriophage has a head region containing the genetic material DNA. Collar region contains protein sheath. It has a tail which is a hollow tube through which the nucleic acid passes during infection. At the end of the tail there is a base plate and tail fibers are involved in the binding of the phage to the bacterial cell. Protozoa. Protozoa are unicellular, that means single cell, eukaryotes. Eukaryotes means which contain definite nucleus. Protozoa are located in moist habitats. Free living species inhabit freshwater and marine environments, and terrestrial species inhabit decaying organic matter. Some species are parasites of plants and animals. Protozoan species are aerobic, which aerobic means which require oxygen. But some are anaerobic species, that means does not require oxygen, have been found in the human intestine and animal rumen. They have a cell membrane. Many protozoan species move independently by one of the three types of locomotor organelles. Okay, these are flagella, cilia and pseudopodia. How they are reproducing? Protozoans reproduce by asexual methods, sexual reproduction. For examples, amoeba, euglena, paramecium. Here we can see the structure of amoeba. This is a large nucleus. Here we can see cell membrane. These are nothing but pseudopodia and cytoplasm, food vacuole, food being engulfed, and contractile vacuole. And here is the structure of paramecium, contractile vacuole, radiating canals, A small micronucleus, macronucleus, cytoplasm, food vacuoles, pellicle, oral groove, buccal cell, cell mouth, anal pore. Structure of bubulina. Here we contain allos, flagellum, contractile vacuole, photoreceptor, stigma or iceberg, chloroplast, nucleus, and cytoplasm. Okay, this is nothing but flagellum. Locomotory organ of bubulina is flagellum, and amoeba is pseudopodia, and paramecium is cilia. Protozoa, unicellular, eukaryotes. Okay, that means single celled, and they located in moist habitats. Moist habitats, freshwater and marine environments, and terrestrial also. Some of the species are parasites of plants, and some are animals. Plants and animals. Protozoan species are aerobic, but some anaerobic species have been found in the human intestine and animal rumen. They have a cell membrane. Many protozoan species independently by one of the three types of locomotory organelles. Okay, these are about the protozoa. Examples: amoeba, euglena, and paramecium. Next is structure of amoeba. We had already seen the structure of amoeba. Amoeba has no definite shape. Okay. It has finger-like projections. What are they? They are called as pseudopodia. What is the purpose of pseudopodia? Pseudopodia help in nutrition and locomotion. An outer cell membrane encloses cytoplasm. Cytoplasm is differentiated into two parts. What are they? Ectoplasm, outer clear transparent portion. What is endoplasm? Inner, viscous, translucent, and granular part. The endoplasm appears granular and darker in color due to the presence of reserve food materials, food vacuoles, contractile vacuoles, and other cell organelles. What are present? Reserve food materials, food vacuoles, contractile vacuoles, and other cell organelles. Due to the presence of these organisms, the endoplasm appears darker in color. There is nucleus in the center which. What is the purpose of nucleus? Nucleus will control all the metabolic activities of the organism. Then algae. Algae are unicellular. It may be single cell or multicellular. Eukaryotes, which means which are contain nucleus, which can carry out. What is the specialty of algae? They can carry out photosynthesis. Where do they live? They live in water, damp soil, and on rocks. How can they reproduce? They reproduce both by asexual and sexual methods. Examples: Chlamydomonas, Volvox, Spirochaera, Ulothrix. Here is structure of Chlamydomonas. Here we can see flagella, iceberg, nucleus, cell wall, chloroplast, pyrenoid, mitochondria, cell membrane. Structure of Chlamydomonas. Chlamydomonas is unicellular. Its wall or spherical in shape. The cell is surrounded by a cell wall made up of cellulose or pectin. Inside the cell wall is a cell membrane which encloses cytoplasm and nucleus. In the cytoplasm, there is a large cup-shaped chloroplast with one or more pyrenoids which store food. To the lateral side of chloroplast, there is orange or reddish color structure. That is nothing but stigma or iceberg. It is photoreceptive. Flagella are thin, protoplasmic thread-like structures. Flagella are originated from where? Basal granules. Below the basal granules, contractile vacuoles are present. Okay, this is the structure of Chlamydomonas. Here's an activity. Take a thin slice of bread. Sprinkle a few drops of water on it. Cover it with a plastic bag. Observe the changes after 3 days. You can see bushy material with black, grey, white, blue, green, brown color colonies. What are they? These are nothing but fungi. You have to place a drop of lactophenol or cotton blue stain on a clean slide. Okay, here we are using cotton blue stain, not safranin. Transfer a small tuft of fungus grown on bread into it. Gently squash, you have to squash the material and place a cover slip and examine under low power, that is 10x and high power 40x objectives. What are, you can see fungus. Okay, these are the fungus grown on bread mold. These are nothing but rhizobus. Fungi are eukaryotic cells. You already knew what are eukaryotic means. Okay, most fungi are multicellular and cell wall is composed of chitin. Chitin is a protein. They obtain nutrients. How they obtain nutrients? They obtain nutrients by absorbing organic material. From where? From dead and decaying substances. So they are called as saprophytes. What are saprophytes? Organisms which obtain organic material from dead and decaying substances are called as saprophytes. They form characteristic filamentous tubes called hyphae. Hyphae are nothing but filamentous that help to absorb nutrients. The collection of hyphae is called mycelium. Fungi reproduce by spores. Here we can see sporangium, sporangiophore, and these are nothing but spores. Okay, these are different types of fungus. This one is rhizopus, bread mold, and aspergillus, black mold. Here we are called as conidiophore. That is nothing but spores. And penicillium. This is the structure of penicillium, blue mold, and here we see a structure of yeast. Cell wall. This is nothing but nucleus. Okay. Here we can see vacuole. Structure of aspergillus. Aspergillus occurs over a wide range of substrata. The mycelium forms dense mass on substrata. How is the hyphae here? Hyphae are branched septate with uni or multinucleate cells. Most species produce a characteristic pigment. These pigments are responsible for giving color to the fungus. Structure of yeast. Yeasts are the oldest cultivated microorganisms commonly found in media rich in sugar or in organic matter. It's unicellular, single cell. The cell leaves elliptical and eukaryotic. Outermost cell wall is made up of chitin. Inner to the cell wall, cell membrane is present. Other cell organelles are endoplasmic reticulum, ribosomes, mitochondria, vacuoles, Golgi apparatus, and nucleus. Here is an activity. Make a suspension on yeast using yeast powder and water. Take a drop of suspension and prepare a smear on a microscopic slide. Stain the smear with methylene blue or safranin stain. You have to observe under a compound microscope and record the result. Some of microorganisms are beneficial to us and some are harmful microorganisms are also present. Okay, these are the diseases caused by microorganisms and the symptoms and mode of transmission, and we are learning how to control also. Okay, here is the disease influenza. Influenza is caused by which virus? It is caused by influenza virus. And the symptoms include chill, fever, sore throat, cough, muscle pains, severe headache also be found in the infected person. Okay, how it can be transmitted? Influenza virus can be transmitted through air, contaminated handkerchiefs. How can we prevent? You have to avoid being close to infected people. Do not touch the nose and eyes with contaminated hands. Cholera is infected by Vibrio cholerae. Symptoms: vomiting, diarrhea, dehydration, stomach pain. How it can be transmitted? Through contaminated water, food. How can we prevent? Avoid eating and drinking contaminated food and water, and also by vaccination. Malaria is caused by Vis microbe Plasmodium vivax. Symptoms include recurring fever, chills, headache, muscle pain, tiredness, stomach pain, nausea. Nausea means vomiting sensation. Okay, mode of transmission is, you all knew that, bite of female Anopheles mosquitoes. How can we prevent malaria? By vaccination, controlling mosquito population, usage of mosquito curtains are advised. Aspergillosis, Aspergillus niger. Symptoms: cough, fever, chest pain, and difficulty in breathing. Mode of transmission: spread by inhaling spores of Aspergillus niger. Okay, how it is spread? By inhaling spores of Aspergillus niger. You have to avoid dusty and unhygienic places. How microorganisms are cultivated, which means how can we grow microorganisms? They are grown in artificial media under controlled laboratory conditions. Okay, it means it have to maintain certain temperature and we have to sterilize this. Okay, artificial culture medium is an environment which supplies the ingredients necessary for the growth of an organism. It's nothing but it is the environment. It will supply the ingredients. Which are the ingredients necessary for the growth of an organism? Various kinds of media are used in the laboratory to grow, isolate, and identify an organism. Depending on the need to isolate and identify a particular organism from a particular sample or environment, different kinds of media are formulated. Okay, these are microorganisms and culture media. Bacteria can be grown in nutrient agar, nutrient broth. Fungi, MRBA. Protozoans, nutrient broth media. Algae, Bristol's media, Venex media. Virus, animal cell. Chick embryo as source for inoculation of sample. Okay, because viruses are obligate intercellular parasites, they cannot be grown in artificial media. They require animal cells or chick embryo. Okay, microbes cause a number of diseases. Vaccines prevent microbial infections. How can vaccines are prepared? Vaccines are prepared from weakened or killed forms of microbes. Vaccines are also prepared by the microbes, but they're in killed or weakened forms. Vaccines help us in developing immunity. For example, polio vaccine, DPT vaccine, they also help in producing antibiotics. For example, streptomycin, penicillin. Okay? If you have any doubts, comment in the comment box section. This is the end of the lesson. Thank you.